Today we are going to speak about the Colleen Cowdery lecture, Lahore attack by Kumar Sangakkar. Now, if you take ordinary level literature syllabus, we basically have four short stories. But the most important fact is, out of those four short stories, this one is taken as a speech. And the other important part is that from a long speech, this is only a part that that they have taken in order to explain about a couple of themes which will be highlighted in the story. So, according to my opinion, personally, I personally think that this will be a very easy short story, or else an easy prose for you, because of the language, and we have a very limited number of themes. And the next thing is that if you study all the quotations which I have given in red color, it will be very easy for you to write answers, because I have given some target questions as well, right? So I have given you the tutorial, and I am under the impression that you have gone through the tutorial before coming for the class. If you have any questions, you can ask the question. So I will start the session. So we are going to discuss about that. But before going to the session, you have to understand that this is actually a part of a speech. This is not the full speech. If you like to listen to the full speech, you can go to YouTube and you can see the speech done by Kumar Sangakkar at the Colleen Cowdery lecture. So we have taken only part of that, only an extract of that. And we are going to discuss about what are the important themes and what are the important quotations that will be essential for us in order to write our answers. Now, if you start with the introduction to the speaker, basically we are dealing with a world-renowned speaker, a world-renowned character. It is very pity that today we have seen from media a couple of unlucky incidents regarding these cricketers who brought that kind of fame and popularity to our country. But unfortunately, because of these petty politics, we can't even realize that how these people are alleging all these wonderful cricketers because of this petty politics, and how they are trying to get the popularity using these people. It's very unfortunate that players like Kumar Sangakkar coming and facing for these incidents. These days, we can see those things on news, so which will be a very painful incident, not only for Sri Lankans, but also other communities who love cricket, who love world-class cricketers like Sangakkar. So if you take the character, basically, I have given you a small character description here. So my dear children, when you are going to write answers for your question paper, I have explained in my YouTube also. First and foremost, in any question, it can be, the second paper questions, it can be a poem, it can be a novel, it can be a short story. You have to write 5 to 7 or 5 to 8 lines about the poet or the dramatist or the novelist or the short story writer. Now here also, these information will be very important for you in order to write essay type questions. It is very important to know about the certain character and a little bit of his family life and personal life in order to write answers. So I have given that here, as you can see on the screen. Kumar Choksananda Sangakkar, a world-class cricketer, best known as Kumar Sangakkara, was Sri Lanka's leading cricketer. He was born on 27th October 1977 in Matale, Kandy. He is a left-hand batsman. Not only as a top-order batsman, he used to play as the wicket-keeper too. Now, these two roles are very important for us. He is world-renowned all over the world as a cricketer, not only as a very good batsman, but also as a really good wicket keeper. So he actually did two roles. Now, as a captain, you have to manage the team. Manage the team in the sense you have to talk with the players and you have to come to decisions. When you are a wicket keeper, you are in the middle of the ground when you are fielding. So you have to give all the instructions to the other players as a team member, as a wicket keeper, as a captain. How to behave and how to place yourselves inside the cricket field. So these two characters are very important when we take his character as a wicket keeper, as a batsman, right? Right. Thank you, Nipuni, for joining with us. I think you can see the screen. We have just started. Nipuni, if you can hear us, please give us a thumbs up. Then we know that you are with us. If you have any questions, you can ask. Nipuni, are you there? You can give us a thumbs up if you are there, so we can continue the session. We are still in the introduction part. If you are there, we can continue. Right, I think Nipuni can hear us. So we will continue. Yes, Nipuni, thank you so much. So we will move on. So we discussed about the player. So you all know about him. He's a very famous player in Sri Lanka, especially among the youngsters. He's the most important player of the team that won 2014 World Cup T20 as well as the team. So if you can remember the T20 World Cup series, throughout the matches, Sangha didn't perform really well. All other new players really emerged and they really played well. But everybody understood that the value of Sangha when it comes to the final, where in the final match, we saw how Sangakkara played really well and kept a good partnership with Tisara Pereira. And from that partnership, actually, we beated number one world famous cricket team, India. And we brought the World Cup T20 to Sri Lanka in 2014. That is an unforgettable memory for us as Sri Lankans, as well as cricket lovers. That made the finals of 2007 World Cup and 2012 World Cup T20. He captained the national team from 2008 to 2011 and stepping down our 2011 World Cup finals. So after 2011 World Cup, he understood that that is the time period that he should give up. And then he moved forward with his work and with his family. And today he is known as a world-renowned cricket icon, not only in Sri Lanka, but all over the world. It is very sad that Sri Lankan people, some of the Sri Lankan people still won't understand the value of these players, value of these personalities, where if you take other countries, they have a huge regard and huge respect for these people and because of their class, because of their character and because of their personality. So, as I have explained, first and foremost, you have to have a certain introduction about the character. So, I have given the introduction to the speaker basically. So, these information will be very important to you when you are going to write answers, especially for essay type questions. If you have any questions, you can raise your questions from the chat section. Then I will see the chat and I will explain to you because I can't allow you to talk. When everybody talks together, it creates a lot of problems and there will be some interruptions because of that reason. Right, so we will move on. We move on to this Colin Cowdery lecture now. It's very important. There is a typo. It should be Colin Cowdery, right? So Colin Cowdery speech, if you take the Colin Cowdery speech, what is this all about? There should be a certain understanding also if you are going to write answers. So I have given you a small description about that as well. The MCC Spirit of Cricket Cowdery lecture was inaugurated in 2001 in memory of the late Lord Cowdery of Tonbridge. So you can see this picture of the fellow. It is held annually during the English summer and has been delivered by eminent figures from across the world of cricket. The inaugural lecture was delivered in 2001 by Richie Bunnett to an audience of invited guests. Kumar Sangakkara delivered lecture on 5th July 2011 at Lord's. So Lord's is known as the most prestigious ground when it comes to cricket. So this speech is also very important when we take annual events of ICC. It's a very rare chance that a player gets a chance to talk or a player gets a chance to speak, get a chance to speak in this kind of platforms because especially if you take countries like Sri Lanka, Sangakkara is the only player to represent our country and do such a speech. And from all the other countries, very renowned cricketing personality will be invited to do this speech. So actually when Sangha delivered this speech in 2011, after his retirement, it was a very proud moment for all the Sri Lankans because we are a very small country. And even though we are a very small country, the prestige that kept us is something beyond explanation. So we have to thankful for these players, as I have explained earlier. We have to thankful these players because of them only our motherland is rising high. Because when you go for countries and when we tell that we are from Sri Lanka, nobody knows, right? So if you tell that Sri Lankan cricket, Sanath Jayasuriya, Kumar Sangakkara, most of the time they know, even though they don't watch cricket, they know these players, they know their personalities. So sometimes they represent our country. So that is why these personalities are very important to us when we discuss about their characteristics. So you know what is now Colin Cowdery lecture is now actually it is done by each and every year by an eminent figure of cricket. Not only the talent of cricket, they consider a lot of things. They are especially about the articulation ability, personality, and what kind of renowned aspects that he has gathered from cricket. Likewise, they take certain measures when they select a certain cricketer to do this speech. So that is also very important. So fortunately, Kumar Sangakkara got the chance to discuss about this, to do a speech about this representing our country. That is very important. And home of cricket is known as Lord's Cricket Ground. That is correct. So if you have any questions, you can ask. Nipuni, if you have any questions, Nipuni, you can ask here. And other students also, they can ask their questions, and I will give you a certain time period when you have any questions to ask. I will give you that chance as well. Right. So we will move on with that. We have discussed about this Colin Cowdery lecture, and we will move on now. If you take the speech, I have explained you this is actually an extract, or else I have explained you this is only a part of the speech. So if you take the full speech, you can see Sangakkara is dealing with very important subtopics, and he gives a very broad picture about Sri Lankan cricket, Sri Lankan politics, and the war zone of Sri Lanka, and what kind of troubles and tribunals as a country that we faced, and what kind of game is cricket, where cricket connects all the people irrespective of their race and religion. So if you take the contents of the speech, you can see the following contents. He talks about the history of Sri Lanka when he starts the speech. Then he talks about Sri Lanka's cricketing roots, from where they have started with Siddharth Vettamuni and all. Then racial riots and bloody conflict and identity crisis. Then he talks about Arjuna's leadership. As you can see here on the screen, Arjun Ranatunga is one of the former members of Sri Lankan cricket who captained Sri Lankan cricket team in 1996 when we won the first Sri Lankan cricket, the World Cricket World Cup by Sri Lankans. Then the search of four unique players, the unifying impact of the 1996 World Cup, that is relevant to here. Then furthermore, he discusses about the economic impact of being world champions, bigger roles for the cricketers. And here, the topic that we are going to discuss about the Lahore attack is also there. So this is the only part that we have taken, right? Lahore attack is the only part that we have taken for our speech. Right. So apart from that, you can see there are a lot of subtopics that Sangha deals with. So you should be very careful that, because some students are thinking that this is Sangha only spoke about the Lahore attack. Right. That is not the truth. He spoke about a lot of things. Under that one theme is the Lahore attack. Right. So you have to remember that as well. Then furthermore, he explains about 1996 power politics, and he explains about the team powered by talent. And finally, he discusses about cricketers, heightened importance of Sri Lanka's new era. So these are the things that he spoke, especially in his seminar, and it's very important. So we will see in a nutshell what are the most important parts that he discussed here. So if you have any questions or if you have any problems with my presentation, you can raise your hand or you can put any comments here in the chat section, then I can explain. So we will move forward with this. Then if you come to the content of the speech, basically we have content here, the content of the speech. I have given that in a nutshell, but later we will discuss that in a detailed manner. Then you will understand what kind of things that we are dealing with and how to write the answers and what kind of themes and quotations which are related to this. The Lahore attack comes under the prose passage in an extract from Kumar Sangakkara's Colin Cowdery lecture delivered on 5th of July 2011 at Lord's. Now these time periods will be very important to you children. 5th of July 2011 at Lord's, right? Sometimes they will be very important to you when you are writing answers, so make sure to remember them as well. As a Sri Lankan cricketer, he had the right to deliver his lecture at this event, touching on history, culture and opportunities for Sri Lanka, as well as a moving recounting of the terrorist attack on their team in a bus in Lahore, Pakistan. So basically we pay our much attention towards Lahore attack only because that is our lesson. But don't forget, as I have explained you previously in the speech, he discuss about a lot of aspects. Out of them, only one is Lahore attack. Then, furthermore, being multilingual and a fluent speaker of English, Sangha's speech was very eloquent speech, packed with emotionally charged expressions. He has delivered his ideas about his role as a cricketer, his patriotism towards his native land, his relationship with his team members and others. So these things are very important for you. We will discuss about them. It is not a must, Huseifi. It is not a must. But when you are writing your essay type questions, it is better that if you can give these dates. Now, it is a very easy day to remember as well. 2011, July 5th. Right. So it is not a must to give the dates and all. But it is important for you to write this information. Then it will be very easy for you to score marks, because even the person who is marking your paper will be aware that you know the dates and the time periods, and you have studied the lesson really well, right? It is not a must, but it is okay. It is better that you can give the time period. So I have given the time periods as well. Then if you read it furthermore, it says, at this event, touching on history, culture and opportunities for Sri Lanka, as well as moving recounting of the terrorist attack on their team in a bus in Lahore, Pakistan. Being multilingual and fluent speaker of English, Sangha's speech was very eloquent speech, packed with emotionally charged expressions. He has delivered his idea about his role as a cricketer, his patriotism towards his native land. Patriotism means ultimate love towards your country. As a cricketer, his patriotism towards his native land, his relationship with his team members and others. So these are the things that he discussed in his story. He discussed about his patriotism. He discussed about his role as a cricketer. He discussed about his relationships with the other players. It is a unique and genuine expression of Kumar about the responsibility as a leader in the cricket. Now we discuss about his leadership and how he act as a leader at that incident. So we discuss all about these things when we move with the lesson. Moreover, it brings out the qualities of Sangakkara as a great Sri Lankan and a great humanist to the world. So apart from all that, as a good leader, as a cricketer, as a citizen of the country, apart from that, we can see he brings some kind of great human values to the story. When we read the story very carefully, we can identify those, what are those human values. So these are the things that brought by Kumar Sangakkara in his speech. So when we read the speech and we try to understand the speech, we can clearly realize that all these things are included in his speech. And when we are writing answers for the questions, quotations which represent those themes will be very important. If you don't by heart them, I'm really sorry to say that you can't score a lot of marks in your examination. Writing quotations, writing relevant quotations for the relevant question is something very important that you have to keep in your mind when you are writing for your ordinary level examination. So with this explanation, we will go to the next part and we will try to discuss furthermore about this. If you have any questions, you can always raise your hand and you can always ask any questions using the chat section. Then Sangha's starts his speech like this. He says, he explains actually, he says that I was fortunate that during my life, I never experienced violence in Sri Lanka firsthand. There have been so many bomb explosions over the years, but I was never in the wrong place at the wrong time. So Sangakkara says that I must assure you that in Sri Lanka, we had the problem of violence, but I was not exposed to the violence because I enjoyed my cricket. I lived in Colombo and I got good security from my family and from the country especially. So it was not a big case for me. So I just completed my work and I stayed there without having any issues. But at the same time, he explains that he had a lot of, even though he did not have a lot of problems in Sri Lanka, as a country, we faced with huge problems related to terrorist attacks. In Colombo, apart from these occasional bombs, life was relatively normal. He explains that he had a very normal, usual life, luxurious life as he is a cricketer. People had the luxury of being physically detached from the war. Children went to school. People went to work. I played my cricket, right? Even though these things happening, even those eventual bomb explosions are happening in Sri Lanka, people forgot everything. People forgot everything with a limited time period. So they enjoyed their life. Children continue to do their work. People went to work. Sangha played his cricket and he waited, right? That was the normal condition of the country. In other parts of the country, Sangha explains, in other parts of the country, though people were putting their lives in harm's way every day, either in the defense of their motherland or just trying to survive the geographical circumstances that made them inhabit a war zone. Now, he furthermore explains that we all are living in Sri Lanka. In one part of Sri Lanka, especially in Colombo, even though we had these occasional explosions, we really enjoyed our life. Our life was relatively normal. But if you take the other parts of the country, right, we call them the war zones, each and every day we can hear how people suffocate from this war, how they try to survive from the war, and at the same time, how they try to save their geographical circumstances, their lands, and how they try to defend themselves to say that this land belongs to us, not for you. So these are the questions that they had basically in their mind. But Sangha clearly explains that for me, it was not a problem because I had a very luxurious life and actually I lived in Colombo. So I didn't have those problems, right? That is the opening part. This opening part will be very important to you when you are writing the answers. So we will move on with the other one. For them, avoiding bullets, shells, mines and grenades was imperative for survival. This was an experience that I could not relate to. So Sangakkara clearly explains in the first part of the story. I have heard about these things. I have heard about shells, bullets, mines and grenades. But I should assure you something that I was never exposed to these things. And I don't have any experience about this as well. So Sangha didn't have any first-hand experience in war. Even though he has seen all these things from television. But he was not pragmatically, he didn't participated or else he was not experienced this type of war scenario in the country. I had a great sympathy and compassion for them, but had no real experience with which I could draw parallels. When he heard the news on the radio, on the television, he felt really sad about this because at the end of the day, all these people are Sri Lankans, whether you are Tamil or Muslim or Burgo or Sinhalese or Buddhist, right? We all are Sri Lankans at the end of the day. So he himself got some kind of upset feeling about that, but unfortunately can't help. Because he can't, what you call, go and help them the way he like. Because of this war, a lot of people suffocated. That is what the Sangha tries to say here. In the above paragraph, Sangakkara really draws a comparison between people who lived in the war zone with terror and fear and how they struggled in their day-to-day life because of terrorism. Now you can understand that. People who lived in all these war zones. On the other hand, what kind of sophisticated and luxurious lifestyle was enjoyed by people who lived in Colombo, including Sangakkara? Both citizens lived in the same country, but terrorism affected both parties in different ways. Sangha tries to bring this comparison in the above paragraphs, how he enjoyed his natural lifestyle while others had a glimpse of hope about their lives. This is what we call comparison. Now, it is a very good example for comparison, the lifestyles of people. So, Sangakkara continued his cricket, but unfortunately, people on the other side, they suffocated from war. We are dealing with the same country, right? How war affected for people in different ways, which is called contrast. Then, my dear children, he explains about this Lahore attack. He comes to the Lahore attack, the unexpected incident which happened in Lahore in 2009. This was until we toured Pakistan in 2009. We set off to play two tests in Karachi and Lahore. The first test played on a feather bed, passed without great incident. The second test was also meandering, along with us piling up a big first innings when we departed for the ground on day three. Having been asked to leave early instead of waiting for the Pakistan bus, we were anticipating a day of hard toil for the bowlers. So he further explains about their tour. They went on a tour to Karachi and Lahore to play a test match. First day, there was no special incidents occurred where they played really well. And second day, a lot of players argued that they had a lot of injuries and all. And they were meandering. They were telling their agonies to their coaches. Then furthermore, he said that to the Pakistan government said that, okay, now Sri Lanka cricket team can leave from here without waiting for the Pakistan cricket bus. Then Sangha explained that was until when they arrived to Pakistan in 2009 for a test match. According to him, the first day passed with any special incident, that is what we call feather bed. All the batsmen batted in a protective manner against Pakistan fast bowlers and spinners. That is how they tried to survive. They didn't want to win the match. They wanted to survive. Right? Then because it's a cricket match, especially a test match. Then at the back of the bus, the fast bowlers were loud in their complaints. I remember Tilan Tushar being particularly vocal, complaining that his back was near breaking point. He joked that he wished a bomb would go off so we could all leave Lahore and go back home. Now, we should not forget that what kind of environment that they are enjoying here now. It is actually a very hot environment. They are in Abu Dhabi, I think. Abu Dhabi, they are in Lahore, Pakistan. So, you can understand their situation. So, at the same time, because of this is a test match, a lot of bowlers, they suffocated from a lot of injuries. Then, he explains about that as well. But it's a very important message given by Tilan Tushar, saying that it is better that a bomb would go off here because they knew that Pakistan is a country where a lot of terrorism activities are taking place. So, he just said, as a soothsayer, he just said that it is better a bomb would go off so we could all leave Lahore and go back home. We don't want to play this cricket match because it is very suffocative for us. So, not 30 seconds had passed when we heard what sounded like firecrackers going off. Suddenly, a shout came from the front, get down, they are shooting at the bus. So, this is kind of an unexpected incident for them. They never thought this type of thing will occur. So, suddenly they heard some gunshots and they understood that some terrorists are shooting at the bus. When it came to the second test match, the team was moving slowly in no particular direction. That is what we call here. No clear purpose to win the match or draw the match. They asked to leave early instead of waiting for the Pakistan bus. Right? So, that was the incident. They anticipated bowlers will have a tough time with Pakistan batsmen. Fast bowlers had a lot of complaints about their physical fitness for the next match. Tilan Tushar especially mentioned about this, saying that his back was near breaking point. He made a joke that a bomb would go off so they all can leave Lahore and go back home. Before 30 seconds, they heard the sound of gunshots towards their bus. Suddenly, someone shouted from the front to get down because they are shooting at the bus. This is an unexpected situation for everyone. Everyone immediately reacted to the situation and tried to find some shelter in order to get cover from the bullets. They did not have any option to do at that time. They hoped and prayed to avoid death or any injury. They were lying on top of each other. So, this is what happened on that incident. So, you can understand the situation as I have explained here. The reaction was immediate. Everyone dived for cover and took shelter on the aisle or behind the seats. With every little space, we were all lying on top of each other. Then the bullet started to hit. It was like a rain on a tin roof. We can see a simile is used by Sangakkara there. It was like a rain on a tin roof. We will discuss about the literary techniques later. The bus was at standstill, an easy target for the gunmen. As bullets started bursting through the bus, all we could do was stay still and quiet, hoping and praying to avoid death or injury. Suddenly, Mahela, who sits at the back of the bus, shouts saying he thinks he has been hit in the shin. I am lying next to Tilan. He groans in pain as a bullet hits him in the back of his thigh. So, we can see a couple of players are now injured, right? They are helpless and a couple of players are now injured. Actually, they are cricket players. They are not terrorists. So, that is the first one. And the second one is they have not experienced this kind of, action. Or this kind of terrorist attack, because they used to have a very sophisticated, luxurious life. So, it was kind of a war between death and life. So, they are praying for the God that please make sure to, save our lives, because they understood that no one can save them at that time because they didn't have proper security, not to the bus as well. Even the bus didn't get the proper security that they needed. Then, Mahela Jayawardhana shouted that he had been hit in the shin, and Tilan Tushar also shouted with extreme agony. Agony means pain. Extreme agony means extreme pain, saying he got one bullet on his thigh. Sangakkara also hit a bullet on his shoulder and he felt it goes numb. He was praying for his survival from this unexpected attack. Sangakkara felt himself very lucky because bullet whizzed past and thuds into the side of the seat where his head had been few seconds later. Sangakkara explains that when I was inside the bus, I saw bullets flying all around me. So, we never knew that what will happen to us. So, what we can, at that time, what we could do is, we can pray for our God, asking our life from them. So, that kind of incident is here. So, Sangha furthermore explains that when he kept his head onto a certain seat previously. He changed the place, but soon after he changed the place, a bullet came and thuds into the side of the seat. And he tells that I was really lucky to take that decision. If I did not take that decision, I would be definitely facing my death now, because I survived from that incident. So this kind of incidents also occurred at that time. Sangha clearly explains about that as well, how these cricket players suffocated from suffocated themselves from this Lahore attack. As I have turned to look at me, I feel something whiz past my ear and a bullet thuds into the side of the seat. The exact spot where my head had been a few seconds earlier, I feel something hit my shoulder and it goes numb. So Sangha furthermore explains that he also got a shot to his shoulder and he didn't feel anything. Numb means he didn't feel anything about that. I know I had been hit, but I was not revealed and praying I was not going to be hit in the head. So Sangha furthermore explains that it is okay to hit here because bullets are flying all around us. There is no alternative, but I pray from the God, I don't need any bullet onto my head. So Sangha knew that what happens if a bullet goes into your head, definitely your death will occur. But if it hits to your leg or your shoulders or else for your arms, you can remove the bullet, and sometimes you might lose your leg or you lose your hand. But unfortunately, if you get that into your head, there is no chance of surviving. That is what Sangha wants to explain here. Right? Then furthermore, Taranga Parnavidhana on his debut tour is also next to me. He stands up, bullets flying all around him, shouting, "I have been hit," as he holds his blood-soaked chest. He collapsed onto his seat, apparently unconscious. So Taranga Parnavidhana is also a player who was inside the bus. He stood up because he can't, bear this incident. He stood up, he just wanted to figure out who is trying to kill them. At that time, Sangha says he saw bullets flying all around him and shouting, he said, "I have been hit." As he holds his blood-soaked chest, he collapsed onto his sad, apparently unconscious. I see him and I think, "Oh my God, you are out first ball. Run out the next innings, and now you have been shot. What a terrible first tour." Now, this creates humor within us. Now, when we read this, Sangakkar thinks about Taranga Parnavidhana. After playing a lot of under 15, under 16 matches, you got a chance to play in our team, national team. But unfortunately, see about your match. In the first match, what happened to you? Right? You didn't really play well. In the second match, you got run out by yourself. Third day, see here what happens. These terrorist people are attacking our bus. These things never happen. So you have to understand that as well. That explained by Kumar Sangakkara at that time. They never had that, a feeling with them. So this can be also taken as a humor, a humorous dialogue given by Kumar Sangakkara, because he, as a speaker, we will discuss about that question as well. As a speaker, he always has to keep the audience within to him. If the audience is not paying proper attention to him, he is fail as a speaker. So that part is also very important for us. Sangakkara mentions about Taranga Parnavidhana and claiming that it was not his tour because he was out first ball in the first match, first innings. He was run out in the second innings and now he collapsed onto his seat, saying that he had been hit. Sangha tries to add some wit and humor in the above mentioned paragraph to the story. I think that one is important for you. Then, it is strange how clear you think is. I did not see my life flash by. There was no insane panic. There was absolute clarity and awareness of what was happening at the moment. So Sangha, as a leader, he says that even though other players are shouting and even though other players are trying to survive inside the bus, Sangha knew that there is no chance of surviving the only chance that they have is that save their lives is the driver should drive the vehicle. Then they can, move to a place where they don't have any terrorists. So Sangha clearly explains that even though it happened like that, I personally myself didn't have any insane or any panic, because as the leader of the team, I should be first and foremostly have a good clear view about this. And an awareness about this. So as a leader, I did not shout. I did not do anything. I was wondering. I was noticing about other people. I hear the bus roar into life and start to move. Dilshan is screaming at the driver. Drive, drive. We speed up. Swerve and our family finally inside the safety of the stadium. So finally they came to their stadium. There was a rush to get off the bus. Taranga Paranavithana stands up. He is still bleeding and has a bullet lodged lightly in his sternum. The body of the bus tempering its velocity enough to be stopped by the bone. Sangakkara explains he did not become panicked. He saw other players reacted to the situation because of the of that clarity and awareness. He furthermore explains how Dilshan shouted at the bus to drive in order to give the message to drive and move fast. Right? Those are the incidents that we can see. Then, up to now, if you have any questions, you can ask from the chat section. If you don't have, we can continue. Please give me your message. I am waiting for your message. So if you are okay with my presentation and explanation, we can go to the other slides. If you feel that I am too fast or my presentation method is not clear, you can say that. Others, please continue. I need your message. I got the message from Mohammed Husevi. Thank you so much. Sasi, Limat and other students, they can confirm their idea. Then we can move on with the session and we can start. Thank you, Nipuni. Thank you, Haris. Thank you, Sasi. We are discussing about these achievements. Don't be afraid about that. We will come to the target questions. When we discuss about target questions, you will get a clear understanding how to write the answers. Thank you, Netujan. We will go forward. Now, my dear children, I want to explain here something. Thank you, Fatima. Now, I want to explain here something. Now, can you see there are some names? Tilan, Tushar, Taranga Paranavithana. So these names are very important to you because when they are having some context questions, they are asking who said this, what happened to him. Now, when we take Lahore attack by Kumar Sangakkara, the most important two names are Tilan Tushar and Taranga Paranavithana. So you have to understand what did Tilan Tushar said and what happened to Taranga Paranavithana. So these actions are very important because most of the time our students, they jumble the answers. So read the paragraph very carefully and try to understand what are the dialogues and what are the things that happen to those people, then only you can identify, right? So you have to remember the characters. If you don't remember the characters, you can't go through, right? So the incident is explained by Sangakkara. Now, and the next thing is, my dear children, if you pay your attention properly, you can see out of these characters, Sangakkara emerges as a leader here. We discussed that as well in the question papers. So you can see his clear view and his clarity about the incident always helped him to have a summary with him. The body of bus is tempering its velocity refers to Limat. The bus is moving forward now fast. Now previously bus was stopped in a certain place because these terrorists are attacking the bus. I think most probably the driver injured himself. I think the driver died. Right, the later the conductor is taking the bus, according to the knowledge that I have. So the velocity is tampering means because of Dilshan. When Dilshan says that let's go drive the bus, they drive the bus forward and they are moving. That is what he explained. Right, I think you have got the idea. That part is actually not in the speech, but I have taken that as well. If you have any doubts like that, just like Limat, you can ask the questions and you can clear your doubts. At the same time, how Taranga Paranavithana stood up because of his unimaginable pain, a bullet lodged into his sternum, the bus also started to move, tempering its velocity by maximizing its velocity. Tilan is helped off the bus. In the dressing room, there is a mixture of emotions, anger, relief, joy. Players and coaching staff are being examined by paramedics. Tilan and Paranavithana are taken by ambulance to the hospital. We all sit in the dressing room and talk. Talk about what happened. Within minutes, there is laughter and the jokes have started to flow. We have for the first time been a target of violence. We had survived. We all realized that what some of our fellow Sri Lankans experienced every day for nearly 30 years. There was a new respect and awe for their courage and selflessness. Now, if you can remember the first three paragraphs or four paragraphs of the story, Sangakkara clearly explains that he didn't have any first-hand experience about war. He played his cricket. His children went to school. he had a very luxurious life. I have explained to you that. Now here, after this incident, only he got the real experience. Even though he had heard from that news from radio or television or from the internet, they never had any real experience. Now only they had that, and now they explains that now we know what kind of suffocation, what kind of courage, right? One should have in order to fight with this terrorism. So it is very important to you, as I have explained, right? So we will move on. After the terrible incident, Sangakkara explains how players reacted with crack jokes and humor in the dressing room. He explains how all the emotions overflowed all around the players. Tilan and Taranga were taken to the hospital because of their injuries. It is notable how quickly we got over the attack on us. Although we were physically injured, mentally we held strong. A few hours after the attack, we were airlifted to the Lahore Air Force base. Ajanta Mendis, his head swathed in bandages after multiple shrapnel wounds, suggests a game of poker. Tilan has been brought back, sedated, but fully conscious. To be with us, and we make jokes at him and he smiles back, right? They are making jokes to Tilan Tushara because Tilan is the first person who said that it is better that we will have a bomb explosion and we all can go home. And actually it happened, even though it is not actually a bomb explosion. Something happened to them, a terrorist attack. So because of that reason, now they all can go home without playing cricket. It is actually like as you can see here, Tilan is also the part of the, as we can understand, Tilan is also a part of the terrorist attack, but he is not actually. As he said, this is known as flash forward. We will discuss about that technique as well, right? Then we will move on with the next one. A week after our arrival in Colombo from Pakistan, I was driving about town and was stopped at a checkpoint. A soldier politely inquired as to my health after the attack. I said I was fine and added that what they as soldiers experience every day, we only experienced for a few minutes, but managed to grab all the news headlines. Sangha explains that you guys are each and every day, you guys are facing these kind of things. So it is not something natural. It is something very natural for you. But for us, we only faced a very few amount, very few minutes. But unfortunately, now we are on headlines, but nobody talks about you, right? The sacrifice that you do for the betterment of this country. That soldier looked me in the eye and replied, "It is okay if I die because it is my job, sir, and I'm ready for it." So it is okay. We are soldiers. We are there to die, right? Then you can remember the poem that we have about the soldiers, right? These soldiers are born to drill and die. If you can remember that poem, here you have a certain clear comparison with the poem that you have in the syllabus, right? Then the soldier looked me in the eye and replied, "It is okay if I die because it is my job and I am ready for it. But you are a hero, and if you were to die, it would be a great loss for our country." So if you die, sir, it will be a great loss to our country. So that is a problem. Yes, that is called War Is Kind by Stephen Crane. In that also we discuss about, he says, these soldiers are born to drill and die. All the soldiers, they know that they are going to die. That is their job. But the soldier says that, "But sir, anytime I can be replaced, right? I am a soldier. If I die from tomorrow onwards, another person will come to this checkpoint and he will do the same thing. But remember, you are a hero. There is only one and only Sangakkara is there to the whole wide world, right? So if you die, there is no replacement, sir. That is why I say that you are a hero." I was taken back. How can this man value his life less than mine? His sincerity was overwhelming. I felt humbled. This is the passion the cricket and the cricketers evoke in Sri Lankans. This is the love that I strive every day of my career to be worthy of. So Sangha says that is why I love this game. That is why I enjoy this game, because the love that I get from Sri Lankans, irrespective of their race, irrespective of their religion, religious beliefs and all, they all love us because we are representing our motherland, right? We are playing for them. We are in that blue jersey, having all that burden on our shoulders. We have to win. We are playing for our country. Doesn't matter you are a Muslim, doesn't matter you are a Hindu, a follower of Islam or whatever. We are playing for you. That love is always given to us by Sri Lankans. That is why I really love my career to be worthy of. My career is something really worth for me because of that reason. Those are the things that we discussed. That is the story in a nutshell. So I have explained to you that as well. Then we are moving to important part, There are the narrative techniques. Now, my dear children, you have to remember, this is not a written story. Sangakkara story is not a written story. So, but I have seen in most of the schools, they have explained that there are some literary techniques, right? So these things are explained as literary techniques, but unfortunately, they are not written. So if it is a written short story, we can say that they have literary techniques. But here it is a narration. It is a narrative given by Sangakkara. It is a speech. So you have narrative techniques instead of literary techniques. Now, if you take other short stories, Lumber Room, if you take The Nightingale and the Rose by Oscar Wilde, if you take the extract the story of Tsunami by Sonali Dharaniyagala, all these three short stories, actually, they are written stories, right? They are written. If you go to internet, you can search and you can get the book, the PDF. But this is a narration. This is actually a speech. Later, it was converted into a, narrative and literary document, and they have given that to you. So make sure to remember, as a narrator, you have to be very careful. You have to be very talented to keep your audience alive. The audience should be with you always. If your audience is not with you, definitely you as a speaker, it's a failure for you. You will become a failed character. So if you take Sangakkara's story, because of his tone, because of his voice, and because of his narrative style, almost all the people inside the audience fall for him, right? They are eagerly listening to the story. That is number one. Number two, the story is depicting different, experiences. Sometimes it discusses about politics, sometimes it discusses about war, sometimes cricket, sometimes past, sometimes present, likewise. So it moves in several directions. So it is not boring for the audience. At the same time, the dramatic technique, the dramatic style used by Sangakkara is remarkably well. The dramatic style means, even though Sangha is telling a story, soon after he tells the story, all these incidents are having some mental pictures in our mind, which is called visual imagery. We discuss about that as well. In this story, we have visual imagery, auditory imagery, and everything. That is the talent of the writer or the speaker. Right now, here, Sangakkara is a very talented speaker. Yeah, almost all the people, they get together and they listen to this. Right? It is very tough now. You know, as a teacher, when your teacher is conducting a certain lesson on literature, you know how much it is boring, right, to listen to a speech. It's very boring. But the talent of the speaker is he or she must try to make it more interesting by adding humor, by adding terror and everything. Then the listeners or the audience will engage with that with more enthusiasm. I think you guys can understand. So we are moving with the narrative techniques. In the extract, The Lahore Attack, we pursue a part of the historical oration delivered by Kumar Sangakkara, Sri Lanka's reputed the most respected cricketer. Through this speech, he recounts about the horrible experience which had to undergo by the members of the national cricket team of Sri Lanka when they were brutally attacked by terrorists on their tour in Pakistan. The third day of the second test was the critical day. The orator really delivers an emotional articulation describing the grave incident. So we will try to understand what are these narrative techniques Sangha has used in order to give this emotional articulation for the audience. First one, under that we have taken repetition of emotionally charged expressions. You can also take this as dramatic technique of Sangakkara's speech. Emotionally charged expressions refers to when you heard about, even though you are not at that place, at that moment, when you heard the incident, mental pictures will be created in your mind and you will create a certain drama in your mind and you will live in that place even though you are not in that place now. I think you can understand that. Right? This can be clearly seen especially in Harry Potter movies. If you have read a Harry Potter book, right, it's very difficult to imagine all these places and all. But if you have read the book and if you are watching the movie, definitely those ideas will come to your mind because you are looking at narration or else a certain book which you have already read. This can be seen here. So they are creating some kind of beautiful mental pictures in your mind. So that is why we call them emotionally charged expressions. People or the audience will be emotionally aroused using these incidents and they are highly dramatic. Highly dramatic. They are pay singhaling mega iginagannayat mitana athi. Ethora singhala api mekata kiyenawa natyochita avastha. Natyekata ganna puluwang vidiyata meka natyak wage kathawak unata kathawa ahagena iddi natyak wage apita danenawa nan api ekata kiyenawa dramatic expressions or else emotionally charged expressions. Now the first one, I have given you the quotation. Not 30 seconds had passed when we heard what sounded like firecrackers going off. Suddenly a shout came from the front, "Get down, they are shooting at the bus." Now, especially our Sinhala Buddhists Sinhala people, they have heard the sound of firecrackers, especially in the Aurudu season. So you know about that. Then when someone is shouting, telling like this, get down, they are shooting at the bus. We can realize the image, the situation from our mind, right? That's so emotional when a couple of, what you call, terrorists are coming with their T-56 and they are continuously firing to the bus. So we can imagine those things. Emotionally, we will be aroused. Second one, Taranga Parnavithana on his debut tour is also next to me. He stands up, bullets flying all around him. Just imagine the, I don't know whether you have seen the movie called Matrix, right? Bullets are flying all around him, right? He is in the middle of the in the middle of the bus and bullets are flying all around him. He's shouting and waiting. You can see he's like a hero in the middle of the bus, but nobody's telling him to get down because he has stood up because of his pain, right? So finally, what happens? I have been hit. He tells a dialogue as he holds his blood-soaked chest. He collapsed onto his seat, apparently unconscious. This incident you might have seen thousands of times when you are watching Bollywood movies and Hollywood movies. Soon after, when the villain is attacked, or else when soon after you shot a person, the person won't die suddenly. He will touch his body, and little by little, he will fall down. I think all these incidents you might have experienced when you are watching all these Bollywood and Hollywood movies. Same thing can be seen here. Even though it is a speech, Sangakkara's ability as a speaker, as a talented orator, Sangakkara has explained all these things with full of emotion. We were not at that time, we can emotionally go for those places and we can imagine actually what happened. That is a very powerful technique used by the orator. This is not a written story, as you can see on the screen. Sangha had done a live speech in front of the members and he has to keep it up alive. You can start your speech, right? But you have to keep it alive, right? If other people are, what do you call, yawning at you, you can really understand that it is going to be a boring lecture. Now, my one is also something like that. Since because I can't see you, I don't know whether you are yawning and waiting, but that's the truth. When you are learning literature, it is kind of a boring subject. To keep the aliveness of the story, it is very important to include emotionally charged expressions which adds more dramatic value into the story. I have explained to you that. Dramatic value. It's like a drama. Even though it is a speech, it's like a drama. Audience will be engaged not only with words but also incidents. It is a talent of a speaker to build up his story an interesting way to grab the attention of the audience. I think you have understood that. If you have any questions with that, you can ask the questions in the chat section right here. You can ask any questions that you have. That is our first narrative technique. Second one, similes. If you take the similes, basically we are using similes, especially in poetry. If you take poetry, you can find a lot of similes. There's a big difference between a simile and a metaphor. Simile is an indirect comparison and metaphor is a direct comparison. So it is very rare that we can see, if you take our four short stories, if you go to Nightingale and the Rose by Oscar Wilde, we can see number of similes. Right, number of similes can be seen in the short story Nightingale and the Rose by Oscar Wilde. In this speech, we can see three similes. I have given them. Not 30 seconds had passed when we heard what sounded like firecrackers going off. So the bullets are taken as firecrackers here, indirect comparison. Then the bullets started to hit. It was like a rain on a tin roof. The sound effect and how they have started to hit is taken as a rain on a tin roof. It is also a clear comparison. Our emotions held true to our role as unofficial ambassadors. It's a very important technique. Now, ambassadors are normally representing another country. If you are representing our country in India, you are known as a Sri Lankan ambassador for India or Switzerland or Nepal, any place, right? So whatever the statement given by yourself into that country will be taken as an official statement of the motherland. Now, the best example is they will directly call you and ask, is something happened in Sri Lanka like this? So you are the person, you are the spokesperson who tells about that on behalf of our country. So you are an ambassador, right? So you know what do you mean by an ambassador. It's a very prestigious job. All the cricketers who are representing our country, not only the cricketers, but also the other players, they are also unofficial ambassadors. Now, previously I have mentioned about official ambassadors. They are doing a job, they will get paid. But unofficial ambassadors refers to, right? Since because they are taking our flag, right? Sri Lankan flag with them. Whatever they say, whatever they do will be subjected always to think about our motherland. Sri Lankans are like this. Sri Lankans can speak English really well. Sri Lankans' behavior is good. How they are going to guess that? How they are going to judge that? From the behavior of the players, right? So here, soon after the incident occurred, a lot of media personalities came and asked a lot of questions about this. They all hope that these people will cry, these people will talk with agony, these people will talk with a lot of anger. But each and every player, right, each and every player from Sri Lanka, they laughed and they said that Pakistan is not, dealing with this problem. It is the problem of terrorism. And we are not afraid for that. It is something natural for us in our country, likewise. And the whole media personalities were wondering what kind of great personalities that we had in Sri Lanka. But if they spoke like, it was very bad, we never thought that this thing would happen to us, we were not given proper security and all, what will happen, right? Definitely, they will have a bad picture about our country. So they acted as unofficial ambassadors. Then no one thought that. They thought that, especially all these media personalities, they gave the message to the whole wide world that Sri Lankans are not cowards. They face these situations and they overcome from these situations. They are that type of people. They are that type of citizens. They are that type of country. So it is also very important their emotions kept to them, even though they had a lot of emotions to express. They behaved as unofficial ambassadors. They did not express the real emotions. They kept them and they thought about our country. That is very important. Similes are used in literature to making writing more vivid and powerful. In everyday speech, they can be used to convey meaning quickly and effectively, as many commonly used expressions or idioms are similes. Now, I think you can understand the three similes and what they are used for. We will move to the next one. Now, imagery. That's very important again. What is imagery and types of imagery? All in all, there are five types of imagery in literature. My personal view is you should know all these types of imageries. First, we will move with the visual imagery. Without a doubt, this is the most common form of imagery. As we know, it evokes vivid images of the characters and scenery. That is called visual imagery. You can visualize the situation from your mind. Then the second one is you have the olfactory imagery. This form of imagery calls to our sense of smell. For example, when he walked into her kitchen, he was assaulted by the scent of raspberry and caramel. So when we have the scent of raspberry and caramel, there can be possible incidents that are going inside the kitchen. What are they? Sometimes they might be baking a cake. Sometimes they might be frying something using raspberry and caramel. So with this scent, we can imagine that some kind of food is preparing inside the kitchen, which is called olfactory imagery. Form of imagery calls to our sense of smell. Then, third one, gustatory imagery. This form of imagery has to do with our taste buds. For example, he bit into the crepe and thought the burst of raspberry wood melts his tongue. So the experience is given inside the mouth, right? How it, creates the imagery. Until he tasted the warm drops of caramel, he tells that. Now you can see, as you can see here, the melt his tongue, right? With the taste buds, no? Melt his tongue. And the next one, warm drops of caramel inside the mouth. So when we tell something like that, we have the gustatory imagery, which refers with the taste buds, whatever the food that we eat, right? Then we have the tactile imagery. This deals with our sense of touch. For example, the splash of boiling water bounced off the counter and singed her skin. Tactile imagery refers to you feel it, not for your mouth, but for your senses, especially for the skin, right? You feel it. That is called tactile imagery. With the feeling, you will get the imagination. Auditory imagery refers to with the sound effect. She found it difficult to fall asleep in the quiet cottage. Where were the blaring sirens and the sounds of midnight ramblers rolling through the streets? So the blaring sirens, we can clearly get the understanding that if the sirens are there, definitely it can be the police or the ambulance. So basically in literature, we have five types of imagery. And we are going to discuss about how, I have given you a very small description about that. Now we are going to discuss about how this imagery has used in the speech by Kumar Sangakkara. We have a question. What about kinesthetic imagery or organic imagery? Very good, very good question. Kinesthetic imagery or organic imagery, they comes under the, we can take both under the incident of tactile imagery, right? Kinesthetic images means your actions are really live, alive, right? which means you will feel them. These two are also very important, and these two are also comes under the category of tactile imagery. Kinesthetic and organic are also coming under the feeling of that, right? So the you will feel the idea onto your body or into your skin. Or else, in some places, kinesthetic imagery refers to all five senses, Haris. All five senses, which means to your eyes, to your nose, to the ears, and to the skin and everything. So everything, when we collectively take together, in some books, they explain that kinesthetic imagery means everything together, right? Not only for your mental pictures, but also for your eyes. Visual imagery is also there. Tactile is also there. Auditory is also there. Everything will be taken together. So you have two ideas there. It's a very good question, right? So kinesthetic imagery can be seen. There is a poem in your syllabus, which is called, it is about the, what do you call, Joker, right? There is a certain Joker, and I can't exactly remember the poem. There she says that, what do you call, I take her nose and I do card tricks. I turn the cartwheels and everything, right? Clown's wife, exactly. Clown's wife, right? In that place, you can find some kinesthetic imagery, the actions that she tells, right? I do all these, what do you call, card tricks, and I always borrow his red nose and everything. And there is another kinesthetic imagery incident where you can find that breakfast by Jack Spivot. All the actions done by the husband is clearly given as a kinesthetic imagery. Those things are really feeling, what do you call, we can feel that, right? So kinesthetic imagery can be seen there as well. Even though the husband is making the tea without making any noise, wife is looking at all the incidents done by him, and she is thinking whether this person is going to talk to me or not, right? So again, there also you can see the kinesthetic imagery, the live actions or the actions I have. Even though it is a poem, when we read the words of the poem, the live incidents can be seen. Even you will feel those live incidents. That is known as the kinesthetic imagery, right? Very important question. Thank you very much for raising that question. Then we have the visual imagery. Let's try to understand what you mean by the visual imagery. Now here we can see several visual imageries. Sri Lankan cricket team traveling by bus by talking with each other and making jokes. So we have taken that as a visual imagery. We have gone all these trips and all together inside the bus, especially from the school. So we know how we behave inside the bus, right? We don't behave inside the bus when we are going on a trip like we behave inside the library, right? We talk to each other, we laugh, we shout, we sing. So this is taken as visual imagery here. So as you can see on the screen in red color, I have given you the example. At the back of the bus, the fast bowlers were loud in their complaints and they are making jokes as well. I remember Tilan Tushar being particularly vocal, complaining that his back was near breaking point. He joked that he wished the bomb would go off so we could all leave Lahore and go back home. So this can be taken as an example for visual imagery. Then the second one, terrorist attack to the bus. Not 30 seconds had passed when we heard what sounded like firecrackers going off. Suddenly a shout came from the front, get down, they are shooting at the bus. So that is also taken as a visual imagery. So when people are shouting, get down, they are shooting at the bus. Whether they are shooting or not, we will get down, right? As a basic example, we can see if you are walking along the road, suddenly stop somewhere and look at the sky and wait. Suddenly stop somewhere and look at the sky and wait. Each and every person, who at least two or three people, will also wait that on the place that you are standing there, and they will also look at the sky and go. Right? That is the curiosity that people have, right? When we say something like that, definitely they will act, they will definitely react to that. Right? That is what happens. That is also called visual imagery. All the cricketers lying on top of each other inside the bus. This is also a very normal incident if you are doing sports, right? They are doing sports, so that is a very, what do you call, simple and natural experience for them. As bullets started bursting through the bus, all we could do, we stay still and quiet, hoping and praying to avoid death or injury. So whether they didn't have enough space inside the bus, so they had to lay each other in order to survive, in order to save their lives. So those are the things that I have taken as visual imagery. You have more in the book, you can take them as visual imagery if you read them very carefully. We have more. Praying of the cricketers is also can be taken as visual imagery because most of us pray or do all these religious observances. As bullets started bursting through the bus, all we could do was stay still and quiet, hoping and praying to avoid death or injury. Then we have getting injured hitting the bullets. Suddenly, Mahela, who sits at the back of the bus, shouts saying he thinks he has been hit in the shin. I'm lying next to Tilan. He groans in pain as a bullet hits him in the back of his thigh. So whenever people are shouting here and there, saying that I have been hit, there is a lot of pain to me. So you can clearly understand what kind of imagination that it creates. We can create the mental picture from our mind, which is called visual imagery. Return to the ground and examining by the paramedics. Pilani is helped off the bus in the dressing room. There is a mixture of emotions, anger, relief, joy. Players and coaching staff are being examined by paramedics. Tilan and Paranavitana are taken by ambulance to the hospital. These are not the things. These are not unusual things for you, even though these things are unusual for these cricketers. Right? As students, these things are not unusual for you. I am pretty sure that you are very much aware of these incidents. You might have faced all these incidents in your life experience as your life experience. So the next one, we will move with auditory imagery of the speech. What do you mean by auditory imagery? With the sound effect, you get the imagery, not with the pictures, right? With the sound effect. The sound of the firing by the gunmen, right? It was like a rain on a tin roof. The bus was at standstill, an easy target for the gunmen. Now, how Sangha knows that it is like a rain on a tin roof, right? Because he had that sound, he never saw that. Sometimes he might have never saw that, right? He might never seen that in his life, but he might have heard that. So from that sound effect, he can tell that it is like this. So in order to compare that, first and foremost, you might have to have the sound first. Then only you can compare. First and foremost, you should have heard the sound, how it feels when a lot of rain is hitting on a tin roof. There is a certain sound, right? The same sound is very comparatively very similar to this. That is called auditory imagery. Groaning and injuring of the cricketers. That is also very simple. When something happened to someone, especially we have experienced how that particular person is groaning with pain. So same thing happens here. With that sound effect only, we know that they are going through a lot of painful and suffocative situation, a lot of agony. If they are not shouting, which means that it is okay for them, but they shout means they are suffocating. He stands up, bullets flying all around him, shouting, "I have been hit." As he holds his blood-soaked chest, he collapses onto his seat, apparently unconscious. These are the two examples I have taken for auditory imagery. Tactile imagery, the feeling. Hitting the bullets in the back of Tilan Tushar, very important. He says personally about his experience from the words, "I have been hit." As he holds his blood-soaked chest, he collapsed onto his seat, apparently unconscious. Hitting the bullets in Mahila's shin, who sits at the back of the bus, shouts saying he thinks he has been hit in the shin. "I am lying next to Tilan." He groans in pain as a bullet hits him in the back of his thigh. So these are the two incidents that we have taken for tactile imagery or with the feeling, right? The feeling is only taken by the people who have really hit from the bullets. So they explain about their feeling. So from that, we can get the imagination into our mind, which is known as the tactile image. If you have any questions, you can raise the questions. You can ask any questions from the chat box. If it is okay, we can continue with the session. Please give me your comments. That is correct, Sasi. We can take Taranga Parnavithana as a tactile imagery. That is correct. A part of the leg, actually. It is a part of the leg, actually. It is exactly below your knee. It is exactly below your knee. That is called shin. Right? So, others, shall we continue? Do you have any questions? I know it is kind of boring, but we can move on. Nipuni. Thank you. Others? Husevi, that's okay, right? We can move on. What about others? Right. We will move on to the other quotations as well. Right. Foreshadowing. When it comes to foreshadowing, it's a very important poetic technique when we are dealing with foreshadowing. But here it is used as a literary technique or else the narrative technique. So first and foremost, we will try to understand what do you mean by foreshadowing. I have given you here the meaning of foreshadowing. Foreshadowing is a literary device in which a writer gives an advance hint of what is to come later in the story. Foreshadowing often appears at the beginning of a story or a chapter and helps the reader develop expectations about the coming events in a story. There are various ways to create foreshadowing. Foreshadowing is also known as flash forward. We have two techniques, that is flashback and flash forward. A writer may use character dialogues to hint at what may occur in the future. In addition, any event or action in the story may throw a hint to the readers about future events or actions. Even in a title of a work or a chapter title can act as clue that suggests what is going to happen. Foreshadowing in fiction creates an atmosphere of suspense in a story so that the readers are interested to know more. Now, foreshadowing is a very important technique. Normally, we use foreshadowing in poetry. But here, in the story, in Sangakkara's story, if you can remember the dialogue of Tilan Tushar, how he explains about the foreshadowing incident before the terrorist attack, he furthermore explains that, as you can see on the screen in red color, he joked that he wished the bomb would go off so we could all leave Lahore and go back home. At this time, we have to understand, my dear children, Tilan Tushar didn't have any idea this was going to happen. He didn't have any idea what is going to happen, right? He is not the part of the plan. He is not a person who supported all these terrorists. But unfortunately, whatever the idea that given by himself actually became real, right? Actually became real. No bomb explosion occurred. But at that time, you understood that, okay, something related to bomb explosion occurred. So you might be thinking that whether Tilan Tushar knew this before. Actually not. He didn't know about this. But unfortunately, this thing occurred. So in literature, we call this foreshadowing or else flash forward. So if you are at the present time and thinking about some incident which will happen in the future, we call it foreshadowing or flash forward. If you are in the present moment and you are thinking about some incident which occurred in the past, we call it flashback. So these two literary techniques are very important to you in order to identify foreshadowing or else flash forward and incidents which occurred in the past and they brought back the memories that you had, which is called the flashback, right? Those are the important ideas that you have to remember. We will move on. Advance hint of what is to come later in the story. Then we have the flashback. In literature, a flashback is an occurrence in which a character remembers an earlier event that happened before the current point of the story. After coming to the dressing room, the speaker and the others talked about what happened, recollecting terrorist attack occurred in the immediate past, right? As you can see on the screen, the red color. In the dressing room, there is a mixture of emotions, anger, relief, joy. Players and coaching staff are being examined by paramedics. Tilan and Parnavithan are taken by ambulance to the hospital. So after the incident, they are in the present time. At the present time, they are discussing about the things that happened. What happened in the bus? We never thought this thing would occur. Likewise, they discuss, no? These things can be taken as flashback. Another example I have given. The speaker and the other cricketers also realized how the fellow Sri Lankan experienced the violence for nearly 30 years. Now you can see the screen. We had survived. We all realized that what some of our fellow Sri Lankans experienced every day for nearly 30 years. There was a new respect and awe for their courage and selflessness. Then we come to target questions. Before coming to the target questions, if you have any problems with these techniques, you can ask. We have a question. Can we take the entire extract as a flashback considering the attack happened in 2009 and he gave the speech in 2011? Exactly, my friend, you are correct. Exactly, that is correct, right? It is actually a passback, not only Lahore attack, but also the entire incidents. Not only the Lahore attack, the whole speech is actually a flashback. Sangakkara is recollecting all the memories, all the things which occurred, 1996 World Cup, and everything which happened in Sri Lankan cricket, and he make the story. Right, exactly, the whole story can be taken as a flashback. Your idea is correct. Exactly, that is correct. So we are coming to target questions. So if you have any problems, we can discuss target questions. I think you guys are with me. I think 8 participants are there still. I hope that I am not boring. I will try my level best to keep it up. So if you have any questions, you can ask, or else we can move on. Give me a thumbs up, give me a message saying that, sir, we will move on with the target questions. Then you can ask the questions and you can get an idea how to write answers and everything. Right. Thank you, Haris. Nipuni, thank you. Others, I want you to engage with me. Otherwise, there is no point of doing this class, making all these presentations and everything. No, that is a very good question by Sasi. We should not tell that the whole incident is a flashback. If you are using flashback in this particular incident, you can only use the two examples which I have given. Because when you are telling the entire story is a flashback, then you have to write the entire story as entire story to give what do you call examples. Now you have to give an example. No, then there is a problem. But you can say that Sangakkara has taken most of the incidents from the past. So he explains them in 2011. So the whole incident can be taken as a flashback. But when you are giving examples, definitely you have to write the examples with that. Right, shall we move on then? I think you guys are okay with that. Right, so no point of wasting your time, right? Right, okay. Then we will go to the target questions. Now, when we get a question from Lao or Attack or any other pros, first and foremost, you have to understand, as I have explained to you, each and every student will have think about the question very carefully, and later they have to, first and foremost, there is a certain sketch of writing answers, right? There is a certain pattern of writing answers. First and foremost, you have to give certain description about the writer or the poet or the poetess or the dramatist. Without giving that, you can't start your answer. So just like I have given that in red color, what is the most important part that you have to pay your attention? Right, when you are writing answers, what is the most important part that you have to pay your attention? Now here, if you see very carefully, I have highlighted the speaker's pride and admiration for his own culture and for the country. So some words are there which are very important for you. What are they? If you take carefully, you can take the speaker's pride and admiration. It should be admiration, not the administration. It should be admiration. There is some problem with this. So we have to edit that. Here we have the, not the administration. It should be admiration. Right? So be very careful with that. There is wrong spelling by myself. I'm sorry for that. Then comment on the statement, the relevant examples. Now I have started like this. Kumar Sangakkara's Colleen Cowdery lecture delivered on 5th of July 2011 at Lord's. As a Sri Lankan cricketer, he had right to deliver his lecture to this event, touching the history, culture and opportunities for Sri Lanka as being moving, recounting and terrorist attack. Likewise, I have given a small description like this, as you can see on the screen, right? Then I have directly came to this question with the quotations. Now I say like this, Sangakkara's pride and admiration can be seen throughout the speech and it is natural. Hence, he is a cricketer who represents our motherland. Always try to write a simple sentence. I have seen a lot of students, they try to write long sentence with a lot of relative clauses and subordinate conjunctions and everything. It will create a lot of problems in our mind because your idea is not simple and it will take a lot of time to understand whatever the idea that you try to bring. So my advice for you is to write small sentences with clear idea. Then anybody can understand and anybody can read. They always wear Sri Lankan jersey with utmost love and patriotism to our motherland. In this speech, there are a couple of different occasions where Sangha depicts his patriotism to our motherland. They were never subjected to this kind of incident before. They were never subjected to this kind of incident before means the terrorist attack. After the incident, Sangakkara explains they all faced to the incident as a one unit, as a team, because they thought they are Sri Lankans. This is one fine example to share his love for the country as a citizen. Now, can you see after giving that explanation only, I have given my quotation to prove my answer as an evidence. We were shot at grenades. Grenades were thrown at us. We were injured and yet we were not cowed. We were not down and out. We are Sri Lankans, we thought to ourselves. and we are tough and we will get through hardships and we will overcome because our spirit is strong. Right? Then you have to write. Sometimes some students are writing their quotation first and the explanation second. That is also fine. Right? No issues. Right? Then I will go to the next one. When Sri Lankan cricket team was faced for this unfortunate incident, the whole world was paying their attention towards the cricket team to find out how will they react to the situation. Right? We have a question. Now the question, I will show you, I will show now the here, the important fact is, can we use the same quotation twice? No, actually, you can't use the same quotation twice. One from one quotation, you can only show one evidence. Now it's a good question asked by Ilma, where she is asking, can you give us the quotations which are very important to you? Now, soon after when we finish this webinar, you will understand that I have actually used the same quotation again and again for different questions in different ways, right? Then whatever the quotations I have given in these target questions, you have to by heart them all. But altogether, I have discussed about 4 or 5 target questions. If you see them very carefully, you can understand that most of the questions I have taken the same quotation and I have used that in different way, in a different manner, right? The same thing I have done. Now here, furthermore, when Sri Lankan cricket team was faced for this unfortunate incident, the whole world was paying their attention towards the cricket team to find out how they will react to the situation. If they react in a negative or arrogant manner, that would obviously bring a black mark to our motherland. Sangakkara and his teammates have understood this reality and they behaved in front of world media personalities like unofficial ambassadors of our motherland because they knew whatever the dialogue and here there's a typo again. Dialogue and voice cut given by them will be effect to our motherland in a vicious manner. This is another example to show his passion and love for his motherland. Then I have used the quotation. This is what the world saw in our interviews. Immediately after the attack, we were calm, collected and rational. Our emotions held true to our role as unofficial ambassadors. So when you are selecting these quotations, the description given by yourself, this is the description given by myself. Your description also should go hand in hand with the quotation, right? You should explain that. You should elaborate that. Now, a lot of students are asking the question, sir, what we should write, sir? Now, we can by heart the quotations. There is no doubt about that. But the problem is what we should write as the passage. Now, the black color one, they're asking about this. Now, what you have to do is you have to read the quotation and that quotation you have to elaborate from your own words. Now, what I have done here is I have elaborated the same quotation into a bigger manner, into a bigger version, right? The same thing I have done. It's not a big deal. If you read very carefully, you can also do that, right? Next one. After the terrorist attack, Sangha has realized how some of our fellow Sri Lankans suffocated from this cruel, brutal war for nearly 30 years. As he explained in the first paragraph, he had a very luxurious life as a cricketer and he was happy with his family life. He explains that he got a new respect and honor about the fellow Sri Lankans who faced all these daily problems in their day-to-day lives. His love for his fans and countrymen clearly evokes his passion and pride as a cricketer, and it depicts his patriotism as well. Right? Then I have given the example. We all realize that some of our fellow Sri Lankans experienced every day for nearly 30 years. There was a new respect and awe for their courage and selflessness. Right? Now you can see here also, I have taken some key words here, my dear children. See here, selflessness. Right? Courage. Right? Sri Lankans. Patriotism. Right? Some keywords I have used. Right? Keywords. So using those keywords, I elaborate my paragraph and I write answers. It's not a big deal, right? It's not a big deal. You have to have your own vocabulary and always try to write in simple sentence. I have seen the biggest problem that you have. You want to show that you are a pedantic and you are kind of a very clever student and you start from somewhere and you end from somewhere else, right? I have seen that. With a lot of relative clauses, subordinate conjunctions, you write number of things, but it's not clear. What you have written and what you try to say is not clear. It is, there is no match between that. So you have to think about that. You should have to be very clear about that as well. Right. So we will move on. Same quotation twice. We have to connect with the quotation with the question in the description. Yeah, exactly. That is correct. We have to connect the quotation with the question in the description. Exactly. And you have to elaborate the idea which is said in this two lines in a bigger manner, right? That is what I am doing here. It's not a big deal, but most of the teachers are not explaining that. What we have done here, whatever the ideas given by these two words, now these are very big words, no, my dear children, selflessness, courage, respect, everything, big words. What I have done is I have taken those big words into small parts. I have said it, I have elaborated it, I have said that. Now here I have said that after this terrorist attack, Sangha has realized how some of our fellow Sri Lankans suffocated from cruel, brutal war nearly for 30 years. I have added a lot of adjectives. As he explained in the first paragraph, he had a very luxurious life as a cricketer and he was happy with his family life. He had a very luxurious life. You can also add, he furthermore says that he played his cricket, his children went to school, even though there are a couple of bombs here and there in Colombo, he didn't care because no one of his subjected to that. So he had this natural life. But soon after he faced this incident only, he realized some of our fellow Sri Lankans are having this experience each and every day. He only experienced this for nearly 7 minutes to 8 minutes. But some of our fellow Sri Lankans, each and every day, they are suffocating from this problem. These Sri Lankans are also his fans, right? These Sri Lankans who face for these situations are also cricket fans. So he had a new respect and awe for their courage because he personally knew that what kind of suffocative situation that he went through inside the bus, right? So for them, it is something very natural, right? So likewise, you can clearly, just like that, you have to explain. It's not a big deal. I think you all can do that. So it is necessary to visualize the whole quotation as it is, or we can change some words. That is a very good question. You don't have any chance whatsoever to change the quotation. If you change the quotation, you won't get marks for that quotation. Now, actually, most of the time, marks will be allocated for the quotation. Less amount of marks will be allocated for the quotations, right? The much more marks will be given for your elaboration. Selecting quotations, byhearting a quotation and what you call writing it on a piece of paper is something very natural that anybody can do that, right? Anybody can do that. You can byheart this. There is no doubt about that. But the problem is how you are connecting, as Husaybi asked, how you are connecting these things together. How you try to show that my quotation, which I have selected from the book, is clearly represents, it is a good evidence to show this this art, right? Now here I have taken the, we have a lot of quotations, but I have selected the most suitable ones to explain my idea. So don't change any quotations. If you change your quotation, they will definitely know that because they are marking a lot of papers. So the same quotation will be there in each and every paper. If there is a change in a certain quotation, they will definitely get to know about that. So don't use handmade quotations. In literature, the biggest challenge that you have is you have to by heart the quotations. Now, Ilma has asked, what are the quotations that we should by heart? Please go through the target questions. Each and every target question, I have given you quotations in red color. You have to by heart all those quotations. Altogether in Lahore attack, you will have 6 to 7 quotations to study. If you study those quotations for any question, you can write answers for using those quotations. I have done that here, right? Marks will be definitely deducted. Definitely marks will be deducted, as I have explained here. Marks will be deducted because they know what is the quotation. Right? They are not fools who are marking the papers, and there are some students who are writing the correct quotation as well. No, when you are writing the wrong quotation, there are some students who are writing the correct quotation. Then definitely you will be highlighted. There is no doubt about that. Right? So next, we will move on. After meeting the soldier and the conversation between them also depicts the patriotism. Now, my whole idea is the patriotism and admiration of the country, right? Admiration of the country clearly represents the patriotism. The soldier says if he dies on the battlefield or at any other place, that that is what he is born for. But he claims Sangha is a hero and his death cannot be measured by anyone. Sangakkara furthermore explains that this is the love and passion that he received from Sri Lankans every single day. So it is hard to give up on his motherland. As you can see on the screen, I have given the quotation. The soldier looked me in the eye. This quotation is very important when you are writing answers. I will tell you why in the next question. It is okay if I die because it is my job and I am ready for it. But you are a hero, and if you were to die, it would be a great loss for our country. Right? Very good question, Nipuni. It's a very good question raised by Nipuni. You can be the most cleverest girl in Sri Lanka in literature, right? But if you are so much talented, we have the problem of time period, right? You will only have 2 hours. So you will have, you have to divide that from minutes, right? So within those minutes, you have what you call 15 to 20 minutes for one question. 15 to 20, 25 minutes for one question. So within that time period, I think with your legible handwriting, with legible handwriting, you can write 4 quotations with explanations. But if you can write more than 4, you are superb. But definitely, I know the problem will arise if you write more than 4 quotations for the next question, you will run out of time. Right? That question will definitely occur. So 4 quotations are much more enough to explain your answer. So my advice is to stick to 4 quotations. 4 quotations are much more enough. Exactly. There is nothing to ask. Quotations may differ according to the question. Definitely. Now, I am dealing all, soon after I finish this, I will explain. Each and every quotation I have taken in this question is related to what? Admiration of the country and the patriotism. I will show you one by one. See, right? First one. This is my question. First one, what is the question? The speaker's pride and admiration of his own culture and the country. What do you mean by this? Just read the question, Puta. What do you mean by this? Right? What do you mean by this? Admiration of his own culture and for the country. Give me one word for this. What is the one word for this? If you take one word for this, there is nothing. What is there? It says patriotism, right? This is one word that I have used, patriotism. So each and every quotation which I have taken here is regarding patriotism, ultimate love for the country. How to select that? Check whether you have the word Sri Lankans. When you have the word Sri Lankans, it clearly shows our patriotism, right? Look at the what you call quotations which I have taken here, first one. Right, let's go to the first one. See the first one. See, we were shot at grenades, we were thrown at us, we were injured, and yet we were not cowed. We are Sri Lankan. Nah, right. Can you see the quotation here? See, we are Sri Lankan. Right, second one. Right, what is the second one here? This is what the world saw in our interviews immediately after the attack. We were calm and collected and rational. Our emotions held true. Our role as unofficial ambassadors. Who are these unofficial ambassadors? Sri Lankan cricketers. Why they become unofficial ambassadors? Because I have explained to you that. Right, because of their actions, they are going to decide about their future and the Sri Lankans' future and the Sri Lankan culture and everything. Let's go to the next one. But does again, you can see, can you see the word Sri Lankans? We all realize that some of our fellow Sri Lankans, again, he talks about the admiration of the country. He always try to push forward his country. Soldier is representing one part. These innocent civilians are representing one part. The Sri Lankan cricketers are also representing one part. All these people get together, they are representing what? They are representing Sri Lanka. That's it. Very simple, no Puta. You can understand that. Soldier, definitely the soldier has ultimate love for the country. That is why he is on the battlefield in order to save our country from the terrorists, right? What do you call? Then take the character of innocent civilians who are living on these war zones. Why they are, what do you call, putting their life in danger? They do not like to give up all their land and go back to, what do you call, other places because they love their land. But what is that called when you love your land? That is called patriotism. They love their country. So they don't like to go away. They like to stay in those places even though terrorist people are doing their activities, right? On the other hand, take the what you call cricketers, what they are doing. We are in that blue color jersey with our flag and all. What they are doing normally? They, what you call, play cricket. It is true that they are getting a certain amount of what you call money for that. That's a different case. But at the end of the day, all these what you call cricket matches, they are doing all these World Cups and Champions Trophies and everything. Why they are doing all this stuff? For the betterment of the country. To bring some kind of pride and admiration for the country. Right? That is what the question has. You have to think like that. That thinking pattern should be there. Then you know what kind of quotation I should select. I will show you one by one. Now, this is my first one. We are running out of time. So, we will try to discuss all. Right? So, this is my first one. Then I will go to the next one. Target question 2. What is the question? The Lahore attack is a mere description of speaker's tension experienced and courage shown. Is this an adequate assessment for the extract set on your study? Comment on the statement with relevant examples. Now, what is the question he asked from us? Okay, if you take the, what do you call, lesson Lahore attack by Kumar Sangakkara, do you think that in that story, Sangha has explained about only about what? Sangha has spoke only about 2 things. What are the two things? Tension and courage. Do you think this is correct? Whether Sangha has spoken only about tension and courage? If it is not, comment then. What else he has talked about? You have to show it now, right? Do we have a question? Wait. Right, okay, patriotism. What else? Now see, again, I am taking that opening paragraph. See, Lahore attack is a part of Kumar Sangakkara's Colleen Cowdery lecture. Opening paragraph. In his speech, he mentions about number of topics which are relevant to Sri Lanka and Sri Lankan cricket. However, it is difficult to agree. And I am coming to the answer. See, can you see that? However, it is difficult to agree, which means I am not agree with the above mentioned statement because it is not a mere description of speaker's tension and courage, right? Okay, we can find number of other themes in the speech such as and have answers, patriotism, selflessness, humanity, and leadership. Since because we have these themes as well, we cannot say that this story is a mere description of speaker's tension and courage. So now, one by one, we are going to explain that. Now, I have told you in our previous one, we wrote about patriotism. Now, can you understand? Same thing can be wrote under the theme of patriotism. Can you understand that? The same quotations which I have used the previous slide to write answers to show the evidence under the category of patriotism, we can use same quotation here also to show the patriotism. Right? That is what I have explained to you. If you are smart enough, you can select the same quotation, you can write the answers. Then selflessness, we have different one. Humanity, again, we can use the same quotation. Leadership, okay, also we can use the same quotation. Now, let's we discuss with the examples. Number one, there are a couple of occasions where Sangakkara mentions about how honorable and proud he is to be a Sri Lankan. He explains how his teammates faced the terrible attack as a team. Right? Furthermore, as Sri Lankans and how they came over it. This is where I will erase this, right? This is where we can find his patriotism and his passion as a cricketer to his motherland. Now see the quotation I have taken. We were shot at, grenades were thrown at us, we were injured and out, but we are Sri Lankans, we thought to ourselves. Can you see the same quotation which I have used in the previous question, also used here? That is the talent that you should have. Next one. Even in the hostile situation, he and his teammates understood the reputation of the motherland is with them. They behaved like unofficial ambassadors in front of the world, and it depicts his calm and rational behavior as a cricketer. Right? Now, see the quotation which I have taken here. This is what the world saw in our interviews immediately after the attack. We were calm and collected and rational. Our emotions held true as our unofficial ambassadors. See the technique which I have used here. I have used the same quotation again and again, again and again, to show that in different perspectives. First, I discussed with that about the patriotism. Now I am discussing about also patriotism, but in a different manner. How? About the calm and rational behavior as a cricketer. Right? I think you guys can understand me. Let's go to the next one. Right. See the next one. We can clearly see his leadership quality as well in his extract. When the bullets are flying all around them inside the bus, Sangakkara was not hesitated and he never panicked as a leader. His behavior can be clearly compared with the other players. As a leader, he saw everything quite clearly and he did not panic. His awareness about the incident is quite admirable. This is one of the major qualities of Sangakkara in the field and off the field. He reads his game very cleverly as he come down to bat at number 3 or number 4. Right? As a leader, when other players were shouting, Mahela was shouting, Tilan Tushar was shouting, Taranga Parnavithana was shouting, even Dilshan was shouting. But Sangakkara, he never shouted. He experienced everything inside the bus. His calm and clarity was there. Can you see the example here? There was no insane panic. There was absolute clarity and awareness of what was happening at that moment. As a leader, his leadership quality can be seen. Right? Now, in Singhala we call, the Singhala students will understand, Pissu kalabala unata, doctor kalabala venne. Right? Even inside the asylum, when the mad people are, what do you call, shouting and doing all this bad stuff, the doctor won't doing like that because he's the doctor, right? So he knows what is going on. Just like that, we can see his leadership quality. Then furthermore, Sangakkara's humanity is also exposed in his speech in couple of occasions. When he enjoyed his cricket in Colombo, he did not have any idea how his fans suffocated from brutality of war for more than 30 years. Right? Definitely there will be a question, right? Each and every O-level paper, definitely there will be 4 questions from pros, right? Because they know that students are, what do you call, getting ready from the pros, according to the pros that they like. Some are selecting, Nightingale and the Rose by Oscar Wilde. So definitely there will be a question. Lahore attack, definitely there will be a question, right? Extract from Wave by Sonali Dharaniyakala, definitely there will be a question. Otherwise, how they are going to make the paper? It is definitely compulsory. It is compulsory. It is compulsory for them to put a question, but it is not compulsory for you to write an answer from Lahore attack if you don't like that. Then you can go for another thing. If you don't like Lahore attack, then you join with Lumber Room. Then you join with Nightingale and Rose by Oscar Wilde. it is a compulsory for the examination department to put the question. There is no doubt about that. But it is not compulsory for you to write an answer from Lahore Attack if you don't like Lahore Attack. You can select Lambaru. If you don't like Lambaru, you can select Nightingale and the Rose by Oscar Wilde. If you don't like all the three, there is no option. You have to go with Extract by Weu by Sonali Baraniagal. There is no hard and fast rule. That is why I said, before going for the papers, have a certain mindset, right? What we are going to write, what is the question is all about, what kind of paper that we are getting ready for. It is very important to have that mindset with you children, otherwise you can't write. That is why I am doing all these YouTube videos, how to write answers, how to do these, time management and everything. It's very important, right? Please ask those questions. Then, furthermore, we will move on. There was no insane panic. There was absolute clarity and awareness of what was happening at that moment. Sangakkara's humility is also exposed in his speech in a couple of occasions when he enjoyed his cricket in Colombo. He did not have any idea how his fans suffocated from brutality of war for more than 30 years. Let's go for the quotations. Soon after the Lahore attack, he realizes the brutality and terror created by terrorism. How most of the Sri Lankans spent their lives every day by putting their lives in danger. He had an awe and respect for their courage. His selflessness as a cricketer and human quality can be seen in the speech. Following quotation will be an ideal example for that. We all realize that's what some of our fellow Sri Lankans experienced every day for nearly 30 years. There was a new respect and awe for their courage and selflessness. He furthermore explains about his love and gratitude fellow Sri Lankans as a cricketer. He considers himself to be lucky and honorable for the tremendous love offered by Sri Lankan fans. The conversation with the soldier also depicts his humane quality when he explains about the value of the soldier's statement. Right? Let's go for the quotation. That soldier looked me in the eye and replied, "It is okay if I die because it is my job and I am ready for it. But you are a hero, and if you die, it would be a great loss for our country." I was taken back. This is the important part. This is the important part which shows his, humanity. I was taken back. How can this man value his life less than mine? His sincerity was overwhelming. I felt humbled, right? This is the passion that cricket and cricketers evoke in Sri Lankans. This is the love that I strive every day of my career to be worthy of, right? With all these examples, one can clearly understand Lahore attack is not a mere description of tension and courage because there are a lot of other aspects and themes related to the story. Done, right? So that is how you are going to write the answers. If you have any questions, you can ask questions just like Ilma, right? And others. Shall we move on? Am I too fast? Because I discussed a little bit fast. So you have a lot of things to discuss, right? Now you must understand, I have used same quotation here and there again and again in different perspectives. Can you see that? Right? Again and again with different perspectives. Now, the best example is this one, right? First, I took this quotation to show soldier's ultimate love for his motherland as well as Sangha, right? Previous question. Now, I have taken this quotation to show Sangha's humanity and the soldier's humanity as well, both. It is up to you to decide, right? How you are going to write. Quotation doesn't matter. With that quotation, you have to have the ability to create one quotation in different perspectives. That is your talent. That is kind of a talent that you should possess. Right? Okay, then we will move on to the next question. Let's see. I think you guys can see the screen. In which ways does Sangakkara's speech help a youngster to build up his personality? A target question. If you are a youngster, if you have a brother or a brother who is playing cricket, if his ideal character is Sangakkara, you give this lesson to read to that fellow. And you are asking what kind of lessons that you can take from Sangakkara's character, especially about the personality. Right? So I have given you the same, introduction like this. Kumar Chokshanan Sangakkara, world-class cricketer, best known for as Kumar Sangakkara, was Sri Lanka leading cricketer. He was born in 27th of October 1977 in Malabe, Kandy. He is a left-hand batsman, not only a top-order batsman, he used to play with the wicket keeper. Likewise, I have given that. That is something natural. Now you know what to do with that. You just give up this paragraph. Now you know what is there, right? Then you will go to the question. He was the only Sri Lankan cricketer who had the privilege of delivering Colin Cowdrey lecture. Right. Sangakkara is a hero. Now these days, if you are in, social media, you can see how people support for him, no? If you are in social media, you can see how much love that people possess towards him because of his class, because he's a character, right? Sangakkara is a hero of each and every youngster because of his outstanding classical cover drives as a batsman, right? Outstanding cover drive. We discuss about that. All these boys will agree with me, right? As an outstanding personality in world cricket, as a fine orator, with he's not only an outstanding personality with speech, but also he's a fine orator with his admirable articulation. Articulation means this way of delivering a speech, way of dealing with the language, his spoken English ability, right? A youngster can add a lot of personality traits from his speech, which will be very important for his life. They are, see what I have taken again, patriotism, humanity, courage and selflessness and leadership. Now, can you see, I am taking the same theme again and again and again in different occasions. Can you understand that? That is the talent of the writer, right? You have to agree with that. Now, first one, patriotism can be seen throughout the story. Sangha expresses his love as a cricketer to his motherland and his countrymen in different occasions. His attitude towards patriotism is expressed in the following extract. I have given the same quotation. Can you see this? Now, Ilma asked the question, sir, how to select? Now, Ilma, you should be very cunning. Each and everyone is very cunning because you have 8, you have 9 subjects to study, Noputa. You have history, you have science. You should be smart enough to, right, study them in a smart manner without paying so much attention for one subject. Now, literature, you have tons and tons to study. But if you select Sangakkara's story, right, with few quotations, you can write a lot of answers. That is why in the YouTube video also I have explained, if I were you, I will definitely go with this. Not because I don't like for those other short stories. This one is much more easy. Language is easy. Anybody can understand. Anybody can go with this. Right? That is why I am explaining you. Right? Then the next one. Even though he is a world famous cricket icon, his humbleness and humanity is beyond explanation. This is another personality trait. Right? Even though he is a world famous cricket icon, his humbleness and humanity is beyond explanation. This is another personal trait a youngster can add to his or her life. His down-to-earth attitude towards the soldiers is a clear expression of Sangha's humanity. When he says he cannot realize how to measure the value of one's life based on his profession or popularity, I was taken back. How can this man value his life less than mine? His sincerity was overwhelming. I felt humbled. This is the passion that cricket and cricketers evoke in Sri Lanka. This is the love that I strive every day of my career to be worthy of. Now, the first quotation we have taken for patriotism. Second quotation we have taken for humbleness and humanity. Next one. His courage as a captain, as a team member, is also very important for a youngster. A youngster can learn how to handle tense and pressure in crucial circumstances. See the quotation. Sangha never panicked during the situation. He tried to understand how to deal with the situation with the presence of mind. Very important word, presence of mind, sthanochita prajñāva, when other players were troubling themselves to face the situation. Below quotations are ideal examples for his leadership, bravery and courage as a sportsman. See what are the quotations I have taken. There was no insane panic. There was absolute clarity and awareness of what was happening at that moment. We were shot at, grenades were thrown at us. We were injured and yet we were not cowed. We were not down and out. Right? From the above quotations, a youngster can add much to his or her life from Sangha's character. His modesty and class is such that he has nominated for the position of president of ICCE. For ICC. This is what Angelo Matthews has expressed about him, and that expression sums it all. So this one I have not taken from the speech, but I have taken from outside. You can use some outside quotations in order to prove your fact. Not 5 or 6, but when you are starting, when you are ending, you can use some, what do you call, quotations from outside, and you can, what do you call, use a beautiful ending. Now here, this is the ending which I have given, where Angelo Matthews, the former Sri Lankan captain, who explains, I was not lucky enough to see Donald Bradman. Donald Bradman is known as the greatest batsman of world cricket. But he says, but I have seen Sangha. That's it. So we can understand the class that he has, right? So Matthews says that Donald Bradman is known as the greatest batsman of all world cricket. Unfortunately, I was not lucky enough to see him, right? But I'm fortunate to see Sangha. So you can see the class, right? So this is how you are going to write answers. Don't think in a complex manner. A lot of students, they are thinking in a very complex manner, right? Don't do like that. Just give your opinion in very short sentences and what do you call, express that. That's it. Don't go for a lot of complexities, right? Then you will have a lot of problems. Right. We'll go to the next one. Fourth one. If you guys are okay with that, I can move on. If you have some questions, you can mention here. Shall we move on? Nipuni, Ilma, Huseifi, Nitujan. Okay, Museifi, Huseifi is okay. We will move on, Nipuni. Right. We will go to the fourth one. Right. What is the question? The prose Lahore Attack by Kumar Sanatkar reveals the humanity and sensitivity of a great person. So these are the two words that I'm highlighting. Humanity and sensitivity. Kumar Sanatkar received an invitation to deliver MCC Cowdery Memorial Lecture in 2011 at Lord's. He did not pick one of the many topics being debated today, such as the role of cricket or the future of the cricket. While others in general strive to preserve their respect of their homeland in front of international audience at such place, Sangha not only shows himself but also the unduly critical of the cricket in Sri Lanka. There are a number of occasions we can find his humanity and sensitivity in the speech. Sangha didn't have any first-hand experience about war or terrorism. He clearly explains he enjoyed his life in Colombo while some of the fellow Sri Lankans suffocated from the brutality of terrorism all around the world. Now, I have taken the same quotations, right? See, I was fortunate that during my life, I never experienced violence in Sri Lanka firsthand. There have been so many bomb explosions over the years, but I was never in the wrong place at the wrong time. In Colombo, apart from these occasional bombs, life was relatively normal. People had the luxury of being physically detached from the war. Children went to school. People went to work. I played my cricket. In other parts of the country, though people were putting their lives in harm's way every day, either in the defense of their motherland or just trying to survive the geographical circumstances that made them inhibit a war zone. Soon after he became a target for the gunmen in Lahore, he realized the pitiful and dangerous situation of fellow Sri Lankans who face the situation each and every day. Then we can see his humanity towards his cricket fans. He understood the danger of violence for a few minutes. He never knew the real situation of the country at that time. Later, he realized it. Below quotation is a fine example for that. Now here I have taken that. For them, avoiding bullets, shells, mines and grenades was imperative for survival. This was an experience that I could not relate to. I had great sympathy and compassion for them, but had no real experience with which I could draw parallels. Again, shows his humanity for these people who are suffocating it. Soon after, he realized that he changed his views and his humane quality becomes transparent. We all realize that what some of our fellow Sri Lankans experience, same quotation I have used here as well. His humanity can be identified in the following situation. He met the soldier when he was driving to Colombo and stopped in a checkpoint. The soldier explained to him how important his life to our country. The soldier furthermore explains it is okay for him to die because he is ready for that. His life is replaceable with another soldier. But there is no one, there is one and only Sangha for Sri Lanka. This statement added emotional shock in Sangha, and he explains this with utmost humility and sensitivity. That soldier looked me in the eye and replied, "It is okay if I die because it is my job and I am ready for it. But you are a hero, and if you were to die, it would be a great loss for our country." Right? That is how he lived. Now he furthermore explains that one as well. I was taken back. How can this man's value his life less than mine? So you have the words as well. His sincerity was overwhelming. I felt humbled. This is the passion that cricket and cricketers evoke in Sri Lankans. That is the love that I strive every day of my career to be worthy of. Right? These are the things that we have discussed. Now, if you take overall comment on this full story, I am giving an overall comment and we will finish from there today's webinar. Sangakkara starts his speech by telling his audience about the history of Sri Lanka and her people. He is proud of his country's heritage, close-knit families, strong communities, fiercely hospitable culture. These words are very important, my dear children. You have to, what you call, go through with these words. Close-knit families, strong communities, and fiercely hospitable culture. He describes how the game first provides an opportunity for affluent Sri Lankans of all races. Affluent Sri Lankans like Sangakkara, who lived in Colombo, who had all the luxuries. Others couldn't play that. Caste and religion beliefs to come together to indulge a shared passion. Without their caste, without their religion, everybody loved the game. Even if you are a follower of Islam, even if you are a Hindu, even if you are a Buddhist, we all love the game. When we say the cricket, even your parents love. Even there are some mothers who really love the game, right? Sometimes they even cry saying that Sri Lanka lost the game, right? Yes, if you have any questions, right? even the, I have seen that in some of the houses like even mother doesn't know anything about cricket, but when she heard the news that okay, Sri Lanka lost the final, sometimes they cry, right? That is the passion that they share, whether we like it or not, right? So when the game is open, the masses, it solidifies the place of the very English game in Sri Lankan hearts. Sangakkara is fiercely protective to the unifying elements of this game. He admits that Sri Lankan cricket players first had to overcome prevail national sense of ennui and dysfunction before they could succeed as a national team. However, he draws on the history of his childhood experience to assure us that the struggle to incorporate a strong Sri Lankan identity into sport has been well worth the effort. Right? It's the overall comment I have given to you. Then furthermore, Sangakkara is fairly unapologetic. Unapologetic about his belief that cricket has proved an avenue for Sri Lankans to transcend their brutality of war. These things are very important, as I have explained to you. Please highlight that. Transcend the brutality of war, right? Because of cricket and shared passion, everybody get on with that. If you take Sri Lankan cricket team, Muthaiah Muralidharan is a follower of Hindu. Purves Maharupi is a follower of Islam. Angelo Matthews is a follower of Christianity, right? And Sanat Jayasuri is a follower of Buddhism. So all of them got together, right? When it comes to cricket, we all share that passion. We might belong to different cultures, different now. In this seminar also, see, we have Buddhist students, we have Hindu students, we have Muslim students. We all share the same passion, right? Likewise, in cricket also, we have the same passion, right? Torture and persecution. He is adamant that his people can become a peaceful and proud nation, healing itself from within and taking its long-awaited place on the world stage with confidence and courage. The sport overwhelmed terrorism and political strife. Very important, right? Because of the sport, this one, people gave up terrorism and political strife. People all got together because of that. Now, today, present-day situation is the best example. Now, when Sangha is, what do you call, asked to come to the FCID to give a certain statement, right? You can see how people who are in the Facebook are putting all these memes and sharing that don't do this to our cricketers, because that the love that they have, doesn't matter whether you are a Muslim or Sinhalese or anyone, because the love that they have, right? They say that Sangha is this kind of fellow, classy fellow, and don't do that to him. So you can see, nobody has given them money, which comes from their heart within. It provided something that everyone held dear to their hearts and helped normal people to get through their lives. And furthermore, if you take qualities of Sangakkara, it's very important. He's courageous and he's forward-thinking, he's unorthodox and he's patriotic. I have discussed about all four of these in the discussion. So these are the major facts that we have discussed today. Thank you so much for joining with me for this seminar. And today also a lot of students asked, they called and they asked whether they can register. A lot of people have paid money, but they didn't come for the session because that is why I have recorded this. So you can join for that as well. So next Poe Day, I'm conducting our next webinar. You can join with that as well. I'm hoping to conduct Lumber Room. Next Poe Day, it will be on same time period, 4 to 6. It will be on Monday, August, 3rd of August. We are conducting our second webinar, Lumber Room by H.H. Munro Osaki. So we hope to discuss about this, characteristics and poetic literary techniques and everything. So you can join. And for today's session, I thank you again for joining with me. Make sure to subscribe for our videos, YouTube videos and everything. And if you have any questions like that, just like Ilma asks, how to write, what are the techniques that I should have now? These things are normally not taught by a teacher, right? So as a student, as a performer, when you are going to perform, you should ask, so how to do that? Like we have the points, but how to be smart and how to manage our time? So how to use the same quotation again and again? Those are the techniques that you have to learn, right? So when you have questions like that, yes, our class teacher said like this, our school teacher said like this, how to write? What is your opinion about this? Likewise, you can also join. So we will move on with our next seminar that will be on after 1 month, which will be on August 3rd, Monday. So if you like that, you can also join with that as well. It will be also same price, 600 rupees. You can join and you will get the PDF. Now I have sent all the PDFs for you. And if you have any questions in O-level syllabus, my number is always open. You can ask any questions that you have. You can clarify your doubts. You can give me a call or you can WhatsApp me anytime when you are studying, when you are doing, if you are writing answers for the questions and all. Thank you so much for joining with me. Have a nice day. Thank you so much.